You have started an Ask Blog. Excitedly thinking of what your first question might be fills you with determination.
I am Frisk, a human. I am friends with a lot of monsters, and currently acting as their ambassador. Don't be afraid to ask me questions. It's kind of my job to answer questions about monsters now. Also, if you have a question for someone I know, I will bring the question to them. This is a picture that Papyrus took a little bit after we left the underground, and a little bit before we met any other humans. Papyrus just shouted, "Selfie!"
"Selfie!"
and took the picture with his phone.
I don't like this picture. My face looks weird because I wasn't ready when the picture was taken.
Your face always looks weird because you're a weird squishy yellow lizard.
You keep talking like that and you'll be a weird squishy yellow stain on the underside of my boat!
And I know! We're all friends now! This is our friendship selfie! It's supposed to bring camaraderie and body positivity, not sadness and flower stomping! Why must my heart be used for evil?
Congratulations, human! You have started an Ask Blog. You've gained a follower.
Thank you. Please don't be shy about asking questions. This blog was made to help humans understand monsters better. But if you happen to be a monster who is just very curious about me and my friends, that's fine too.
Monsters are scary. Why'd you bring them up here?
Because it was wrong for humans to lock them away, and they deserve freedom and happiness just like anyone else. I understand why some of you might be scared of them, but I assure you, there's nothing to be afraid of. And monsters aren't scary. They're cute.
How's life for all of you on the surface?
It's wonderful. All of us live in this big, beautiful house. We built it brand new. Nobody had any money humans would accept when they left the underground, and a lot of humans refused to sell homes to monsters. So it's been hard. But all of us pulled our money and built this place. Now me, Mom, Sans, Papyrus, Undyne, Alphys, King Asgore, and Flowey all live here together. It's not perfect up on the surface, but I finally have a family. And that really means something.
So, is Sans and Toriel a thing yet or no?
Not as far as I know. But I'll ask them anyway.
Oh, hey kid. How's the whole blog thing going?
Pretty good. One of the questions I got is about you, so I thought I'd ask you about it before jumping to any conclusions.
Sure. What's the question?
You gotta promise you'll give me a truthful answer.
Why?
Because. Please.
Sheesh, kid. What kind of questions are you getting on that blog? It's only been up a couple days. Okay, sure. I'll bite. I promise to give a truthful answer to your ominous question.
So, my mom. Would you kiss her and do gross mushy stuff with her if you knew she was down?
Note to self, stop making irresponsible promises.
How's the volatile houseplant, Flowey?
So I see you've taken Flowey with you. That, must be an interesting living situation.
It's really not as bad as you think.
Gee whiz, this place sure is a dump! Which I guess is appropriate since nothing but garbage lives here.
But you live here too, Flowey.
Did I fucking stutter? At least I know I'm trash! You people think you're so great!
Flowey, I do not tolerate anyone using profanity in front of my child!
Sorry.
Flowey may not be able to feel love, but I think there's more of Asriel in him than he pretends there is. I see glimpses of it sometimes. And I didn't bend time and space to save only most of the monsters. I'll find a way to help him love again. I'm determined to save him. My mom's pretty intimidating, huh?
Don't you sass me, you little...
Careful, bro. Mom might get the soap out next time.
Kobe, bro, again and I'll strangle you in your sleep.
Nobody else knows the truth about Flowey. They only know that he is a flower that Alphys injected with determination. That he did a lot of bad things, and that I want to help him. But someday I'll have to tell them the truth. They deserve to know.
How are Alphys and Undyne doing?
How are both Undyne and Alphys on the surface? Has their relationship deepened since we last saw them?
I presume Alphys and Undyne are still a thing. Also, are they weebs?
Undyne and Alphys are absolutely a thing. I'd like to think I helped in some small way. Normally I go and directly ask them some questions, but I can't right now because they're on vacation in Japan. But I'm pretty confident when I say that they're closer than ever.
Does Undyne still believe anime's real? Speaking of anime, has Alphys ever watched JoJo's Bizarre Adventure?
I actually told Undyne the truth about anime. She took it as well as I could have hoped. She was really excited about the Japan trip when she learned that's where anime's made. As for JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, most of the anime that Alphys had in the underground was really old, so they have a lot to catch up on. Any anime that wasn't made in the 90s or earlier is probably one they haven't seen yet. But I've seen JoJo, and I recommended it to them a while ago.
So Metatron doesn't live with you?
No, he has his own house nearby. But he hasn't been home because he's on tour right now. That's why Undyne and Alphys are in Japan, actually. He gave them an all-expense-paid trip so that they could see him in concert there. He actually offered for all of us to go, but I have school and the others have jobs. Jobs that don't give paid vacations.
Do any of you share a room?
Flowey and I share a room. He just kind of lives in his flower pot on a table in front of the window, so he can see outside and photosynthesize and stuff. Undyne and Alphys also share a room. For obvious reasons. Undyne and Alphys will be home eventually, and then I can start asking them direct questions. Until then, I hope this helps satiate your curiosity.
Have you tried asking Toriel the same thing? Referring to the Sans and Toriel date question.
I tried a similar strategy with my mom to learn her true thoughts and feelings. Things like this are tricky. People often hide their feelings, even from themselves. So the best way to learn the truth is to catch them off guard and carefully watch their body language.
Hey Mom, did you know that Sans thinks you're hot?
Good news, Sans. She's down.
I ship it.
Hey Sans, Papyrus! Guess what time it is?
I hope this is the setup for a pun.
Okay, is it 4 o'clock?
Nope.
Time to answer some questions from my blog together!
And all of them are about you two.
I, the Great Papyrus, have fans?
Begin the questions, Frisk!
Okay.
Alright, here's a question. Why and how is Papyrus so freaking pure? He's just too perfect. Thank you for your time.
Papyrus? So, do you like your new life? And can I hug you?
You said I'm becoming as great and awesome as Papyrus?
Oh, Great Papyrus, will you teach me how to make spaghetti?
Papyrus, slap the booty.
They really like me.
Well, of course they do, bro. You're a pretty likable person.
So, is Papyrus' spaghetti edible yet?
Has Papyrus' cooking improved? Oh.
Wow, rude.
I, the Great Papyrus, will not be answering questions from jealous haters. True fans only. The Great Papyrus.
So, Frisk, I have a question that's been tying my brain in knots lately. How are Sans and Papyrus able to eat and drink things like spaghetti and ketchup?
Why wouldn't we be able to eat things?
Because you don't have guts and stuff.
I can answer this. Human bodies and monster bodies are built very differently. Humans have strong souls able to house vast amounts of determination, and so they have a lot of physical matter holding their body together. Monsters don't need as much physical matter to house our comparatively weaker souls. As a result, monster bodies are made mostly of magic with only a little physical matter, while human bodies are made mostly of physical matter with only a little magic. Our food isn't so different. Monster food is made mostly out of magic. So as a result, it turns into pure life energy shortly after you take a bite out of it. So if we ate human food, it'd probably fall out of us, but whatever.
Wowee! I feel so informed!
That explains how I could eat so fast mid-battle.
Papyrus! Let me have your babies! I'm half-skeleton if that counts for anything! You just gotta get me out of this pesky flesh sack!
Wow, this person's pretty forward. I like their style.
The Great Papyrus is flattered, but not interested. The Great Papyrus.
To anyone who wants to reluctantly answer this, how do monsters reproduce?
No!
Papyrus, cover Frisk's ears!
No!
How are skeleton babies made?
No!
The same as humans? They do the diddly-do,
No!
They do the hex sex?
No!
But these aren't even all the people who sent that one in!
I can see.
And this blog is to help humans understand monsters better. Also, I'm curious too.
I don't see what you're so embarrassed about, Paps. It's a beautiful and natural part of life. And I think if the kid's gonna be flirting with every other monster they meet, we may as well give them the talk, you know? When humans make more humans, they combine a sperm and an egg together, and it eventually grows into a baby human. When monsters make more monsters, we use a similar process, but instead of combining physical cells together, we combine special tiny fragments of magic together. The actual process of how we combine our magic together is pretty much the same as how humans combine their sperm and egg cells together. Any two monsters can, theoretically, have children together, regardless of species or gender. But in the case of two male monsters, they would need to employ a surrogate, since neither of them would have a womb, probably. But Sans, you ask? Skeletons don't have wombs or any other squishy sexy parts, how does that work? Well, I'll tell you how it works. Magic. Use your imagination.
Is it just me, or is there something behind your couch? I know you're there, you sneaky guy.
I didn't know there was another skeleton living in the house. What is their name?
Holy crap, I barely noticed Gasser in the background. You sneaky mun. Love this blog.
Quick, Gasser's behind the couch.
Gasser, I see you spooking around there.
Who's the guy behind you?
Am I the only one seeing something in the background? Or is it just me?
Am I the only person who can see Gaster in the background? Also, tell everyone to say hi.
Gaster is proud of his son. Guys, do either of you know anyone named Gaster?
How peculiar. I'm certain that I've never heard that name before. And yet, why do I suddenly feel full of nostalgic sadness?
Gaster, now's your chance. Maybe it's because the barrier was broken or something, but you're probably becoming more and more real. Just reach out and take it.
This is quite unexpected. I will try.
It's quite clear monsters come in a wide variety of shapes and sizes. I imagine many humans find some more comfortable to be around than others by appearance alone. Whose has the easiest time mingling with humans? Who has the worst time?
Oh, humans love me. How could they not?
Sans?
Especially the smaller humans. I find they're very easy to be friends with just as long as you're nice to them. Greetings, small human. I am the Great Papyrus. What is your name?
I'm Sophie.
Well, Sophie, I hope we can be friends. The big humans are tougher to break the ice with, but that's just my own experience with humans. Toriel is popular with children, but also adult male humans for whatever reason.
Eh, Mama Goat, wanna trot up my mountain?
Wanna have a bad time, bro?
Then again, I'm not the mountain climbing type.
and Metaton is just plain popular, especially in Japan. I think monsters being so different is an advantage. This way we can appeal to many different types of humans all at once.
It's hard for even us Anons to see a certain man who speaks in hands. But if you two want to ask him anything, we'll be happy to translate from wherever he is. I mean, if he's on a sort of different but overlapping plane of existence, well, in the same physical room, does that count as infinite distance or barely any?
I'm afraid that wouldn't help. My boys do not remember me. Anything I could say would only scare and confuse them.
A little late to be worrying about that old man.
Sans, who are you talking to? This is scary and confusing.
Sans? You okay there, buddy?
Is something wrong, Sans?
You okay there, Sans? Something in your eye?
Sans? I'm worried about you.
I worry about you. I'm Sans.
Sans? Who is that?
That's her dad. He got erased from existence. It's kind of a long story, but, I guess I yanked him back into our reality or something. I wasn't even sure it worked, to be honest.
I have a dad?
Did you have to be so rough with your old man, Sans?
Well, it takes a bit more than a light tug to pull someone from the limbo between existence and non-existence. Besides, he's fine. A little worse for wear, but he'll live. Right, old man?
What? How? I...
Old man?
I'm really here. I'm really here.
Yeah, you are.
To the several others who sent questions about my well-being, I am touched by your concern. But worry not. I feel better than I have in a very long time.
Dang, Sans. You pulled someone out of non-existence / the void. How powerful are you?
Buddy, listen. If you ever see my full power, it means that one of us is definitely going to die. So don't ask questions you don't want the answers to.
What does everyone in the family think about old Gaster?
Only Sans remembers me, but the others are very kind to me anyway.
You poor man. You're cold as ice.
I think we may have met. Did you ever hang out behind a creepy gray door in Waterfall?
Would you like some tea to warm you up?
Yes. Thank you, Your Majesty.
Papyrus? Are you okay? You look like you've just had a heart attack.
So, Frisk, Papyrus, how are you feeling about finding out about Gaster?
This is all very unexpected. I mean, I didn't even know I had a dad. And now Sans is saying I forgot him, and I feel terrible! How could I have forgotten my own dad? I'm the worst son ever!
Papyrus. Don't be upsetty. Have some spaghetti.
Papyrus, you better prepare some more spaghetti, don't you think?
That's a great idea! Thank you for your wise advice, Mr. or Miss Anon.
How's Flowey gonna react to another skeleton?
So you're their dad, huh?
And you are the soulless husk of Azrael, who commandeered the timeline and used it as its plaything.
Oh, you'd know what being a soulless husk feels like, wouldn't you? What was it like in the void? Ebbing in and out of existence, able to see and hear your son's awful puns and pasta, but unable to do anything about it. Then again, being their dad, for all I know, they inherited their obnoxiousness straight from you, huh? You're secretly a pasta meme-loving fuck, aren't you?
Hey, Flowey. Yttrium, uranium, nobelium, lithium, potassium, protactinium, sulfur, tantalum.
The hell? Are you listing elements?
Why you know like pasta?
I'm in skeleton hell and it's way dirtier than I thought it'd be.
I've scraped my knee falling for you.
Oh no, you're hurt? Yes, I do think we have band-aids. I'll go get one right away.
Never mind about the band-aid. I don't actually need it, so...
5 hours later...
How do humans have so many channels and so little to watch? Maybe Mythbusters. What do you think, kiddo?
Oh my god, I was being flirted with! How did I not see that?
Frisk has evolved into anime protagonist. Enjoy the unintentional following of 1,000+ people of various genders without ever realizing each and every single one of them is romantically interested in you!
That's not funny!
Frisk, how do you feel about Monster Kid?
Well... they're pretty cute. But that doesn't matter because I'm too embarrassed to show my face around them anymore.
Hey, Papyrus. How about asking Metaton on a date? Come on. I remember you saying that you liked his eyes, and I saw the way you look at his legs. Don't try to deny. Go get that robot cutie. You are the great Papyrus, aren't you?
The thing about that is, my own personal feelings about Metaton's impressive Bishonen charm aside, I don't think asking Metaton on a date would be the best idea. And this is for reasons that are definitely not fear of rejection, because obviously the great Papyrus fears nothing. Besides, he's still touring in Japan, so...
Guess who's back from Japan?
Konnichiwa, bitches!
I hope I didn't keep you waiting too long, darlings.
You know what really gets my goat? Sans. Because Toriel is my goat, and Sans gets her.
Good one. Yeah, I guess we do kind of get each other. Me and Tori, I mean. She's pretty great. That is to say,
Toriel wants the bee bones.
Well, I'm going to Grillby's too, still grilling. You know, the sequel to Grillby's that's on the surface and stuff.
Guys, I think we might need help.
Yes, we might.
Yeah.
I'm really here.
I'm here too. I've always been here.
I am here to save the day! Handstands, Papyrus, and Frisk, paper bags, and coals cut out of their eyes. As long as you wear these patented blush shields, you can blush until you're a tomato, and no one will notice.
Wowie, I feel confident and distinguished already.
Where did Undyne get that sword?
Oh, you mean this? It's my very own real functional Cloudstripe Buster Sword! While I was in Japan, I commissioned a traditionally trained blacksmith to make it for me. And he said it would be too heavy to wield properly.
Well, Alphys, the cutest monster ever, is back. Let the questions about anime begin.
Ooh, but thank you? Really, I'm not the cutest monster ever. There's no need to exaggerate.
You so totally are the cutest monster ever, Alphys!
Undyne!
That's my girlfriend!
So if Gaster's their dad, then who is Sansa Papyrus's mother?
My wife. She has been gone so long that sometimes I forget her face. Sad, isn't it?
Oh, hey, Owen Bing. Funny seeing you out in the woods like this.
Miss Herman, I must speak with you. It's important.
What? I can't hear you. Can you say that again a bit louder?
Miss Herman, I must speak with you.
Tra-la-la, still can't hear you. Tro-lo-lo, come out, hear you.
Did you seriously just rhyme you with you? Are you even listening to me?
Whatever you've got to say, you can say it while ice skating with me.
I'm not wearing skates.
So, neither am I. Come here, you.
What? I honestly have no idea what she saw in me. I was an uptight, antisocial nobody before I met her. She had this joy about her. She made me feel like I could do anything. It's only natural that I fell for her.
So, what did you want to talk about, Windy?
It's unlikely that either of my sons remember her very clearly. She became dust when Sans was a small child and Papyrus was just an infant. But she also wasn't erased from existence the way I was, so...
My dad is a master of romance!
Papyrus? Why is there a bag on your head?
Because of, reasons?
Frisk, how do you feel about Monster Kid? Do you like him back? If so, you should try to talk to him.
Hey, Frisk, I double, triple, quadruple dare you to ask Monster Kid on a date! And before you chicken out, keep in mind that they flirted with you, which means they like you! And if you don't, I'll show them the pose where you call them cute!
Frisk?
Frisk, you should probs talk to Toriel about your love troubles. Motherly advice is always the best. Plus, she seems to get hit on a lot, so she probably knows how this stuff goes.
Why'd you throw all these away?
Because I don't want to answer those ones.
Why not? It's not like it's a secret to anyone that you like the little armless idiot.
Go away, Flowey.
Hey, this is my room too! Toriel! Frisk is being mean to me for no reason!
Frisk, what is Flowey shouting obvious lies down the hall at me for?
They've been lying around and moping like this for hours! And they won't even play Smash Bros. With me!
Frisk, is this about your misunderstanding with Kid? Sans told me about it earlier today.
I thought I was good at flirting. My life is a lie.
Just now you figured that out? You flirted with a lady you just met right after calling her mom.
How do you exactly feel towards Kid?
I like them. And that's why they suck so much.
You really ought to be honest with them about your feelings, then.
It's not that simple, Mom!
Oh, dear.
Wait, I'm scared. What if I mess up again? What if they aren't interested anymore? What if things get all awkward and our friendship is ruined? What if-
Hey! Thinking like that'll drive you crazy, kiddo. Trust me. Listen, I get where you're coming from. I really, really do. But you've really got nothing to worry about. I mean, you're... you... and stuff. I'm not great at giving pep talks. Well, anyway, I found an ask that I think you should read.
What does it say, my child?
Frisk, you're better than that. You're the human that can flirt with anything and everything successfully. You're the human that could flirt their way out of the underground. Not only can you flirt your way back to Monster Kid, I bet Sans and Papyrus could learn a thing or two from you.
I think this person summed up everything pretty well. There's a lot of people out there who believe in you, kiddo. You've just gotta believe in you. You know, I hope that made sense.
Remember, dinner's at 5, so don't stay out too late.
Oh man, look at that ball of determination go! Someone play Hopes and Dreams to get them moving faster!
Gaster, how do you feel about the whole situation between Frisk and Monster Kid? Do you think it'll work out for them?
It's too early to say one way or the other, but I am cautiously optimistic about Frisk's romantic endeavors.
So, since Gaster is part of the household now, does he read Papyrus bedtime stories, or does Sans still do that? Or do Sans and Papyrus listen to the stories?
I was never the one who read bedtime stories. It used to be my wife's thing. Then Sans started reading to Papyrus after she passed. He always was a strong kid.
So, how does Gaster feel about the fact that his sons have big-time crushes?
Gaster, your sons are dirty robot and goat smoochers. At least they would be if they were total nerds!
Gaster, how do you feel about Sans being in love with a goat woman? And Papyrus being in love with a robot man?
I've known who my sons were interested in far longer than any of you have.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Kirch.
Kirch who?
Gesundheit.
Oh my god, that's adorable.
I'll make your last living moments absolutely beautiful.
Oh.
Shit.
Oh my god.
All I'm saying is that we'd, like, probably have way more customers if our store wasn't called Trash Mart. Just saying.
OMG! That's, like, totally our thing! We can't forget our trashy roots, Braddy!
Frisk, not decisively!
Oh, what a beautiful knock! Oh my god, you think it's a door for one? Oh, but three of them. Maybe we'll knock again if we wait.
This is why we never have visitors, Reginald. Oh, you're Frisk, aren't you? How can I help you?
Can you at least ask him to knock again?
Are you...
Please?
Are you kids' parents?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I need to see Kid right now, please. It's very important that I talk to them.
Oh. I'm afraid Kid isn't home right now. Feel free to stop by any time, though.
Oh. Okay.
Oh my god. Caddy, I think that's Frisk right there across the street.
OMG, you're right! Frisk! Hey! It's your fave alley cat and alligator! Did Kid use the pickup line on you yet? You know about the pickup line Kid used on me?
Well, yeah, duh. We told them that's what they should do if they wanted to win your heart.
That or a red echo flower, but then we were like, JK lol, those aren't even on the surface, which is a total bummer, BT Dubs.
Huh? But I never saw any red echo flowers when I was in the underground.
That's, like, because they're super rare. They only grow in Hotland and only, like, right next to lava.
That's why it's super romantic to give someone a red echo flower. Because it's like saying, I'd get burned by lava for you, bae. Winky face! So, like, did the pickup line work? Hey, Earth to Frisk.
Come on, Frisk. Don't, like, put a pen in here. You totally should be here.
Frisk is filled with dread.
No mercy. Looks like free XP. In my way.
This is kind of awkward to ask, but how is Kara doing?
Frisk
in any other dimension of your world. Beware of the you who kills on cue.
I know you're here, Kara. Us Anons, and maybe Frisk knows you're here. Show yourself, or us Anons will make you.
What the joke? Since when have you been in control?
Since now! Brings Kara into reality and turns her into a powerless spirit.
You reach with all your might into the abyss to pull Kara into reality and turn them into a powerless spirit.
You reach, but your hand doesn't hurt anything.
Don't you get it? I'm already here. I've been here for a while now. Nobody noticed. I've got to say, though, this is all going to be much more fun with an audience. Especially since this audience is completely powerless. All you can do is sit there and watch them die.
You still can't touch us, Chara. We're separated by a much more powerful barrier than the one that kept all the monsters in Mount Ebbet. And even with your power, you cannot penetrate it.
Hey, jackass! Such a shame there's a fourth wall protecting me, huh? Tell me how real you totally are. Some might get a chuckle out of this. So, demon boy, since I know you're a child and you won't understand me, here's the short version. I'm not afraid of you.
You're right, but you're wrong. You, dear audience, are well beyond my reach. I cannot harm. This is fine. It isn't you or your world that I hate. But I can hurt you all the same.
Oh, your ass plong is the cutest! I absolutely love seeing the slice of life kind of environment for everyone. And they're all fairly in character. T.Y. for sharing your Undertale story with us. This is where I go to see them all happy.
Because you care about them. Because you come here to see them happy. Because you're too naive to understand. Caring about others only leads to pain.
Kara, you are powerless and weak and stupid for coming back. Okay, you got me. I'm just trying to make you mad. Is it working? Because I want to fight.
Oh, believe me. I'd love to fight you. But sadly, that is quite impossible.
Cool story, Kara. How about instead, for once, you do something that's neither boring or predictable? Because at this point, that's pretty much what you've become. A bland spirit that tries to make other people miserable. Yeah, really interesting.
Sticks and stones, my friend. If I was really so boring to you, why go through the effort of hurling weak insults at me? I must admit, though, I admire your spirit.
What have we done? Kara is pretty much going to cause chaos in the Ask Blog. Maybe it was a bad idea to wake up that guy.
Well, we fucked up. Great job, Tumblr. You gave the demon an audience, and now everyone we love is gonna die. Frick!
You're starting to understand now.
I'm the one Anon who took the genocide route and enjoyed it. Do your best, Kara. Make them suffer before they die.
Ah, now here's someone who gets it. Don't worry. I do not intend for them to die peacefully. Do enjoy the show, partner.
Kara, no!
Kara, yes!
Sans, something wicked this way comes. Prepare Megalovania. It's time to dunk.
See, Sans, there's a new friend scorpion about to ghost or something, and they're planning on killing all of you or all of us. I don't know, maybe you should ask Aster about my belt situation.
Sans, are you alright?
Tori, we gotta go find Frisk. Now.
Meanwhile, on Mount Abbott.
Definitely late for dinner now. Mom's gonna kill me.
Frisk, there's a disturbance in the Force. As if some great evil that was once silence has reawakened.
I can't go home yet. If I turn back now, Kid will end up falling in a pit of lava in some crazy attempt to get my attention. What? What's that supposed to mean? What great evil? Well, whatever it is, I'm sure the others can handle it. I'm no good at fighting anyway.
Oh, but that's not true, is it?
Huh?
You're an excellent fighter, Frisk. You're more powerful than any of them. Papyrus, Undyne. Metaton, Sans.
Who are you? What are you talking about? No. You're trying to trick me. You must be the evil thing I was warned about just now.
Fascinating, isn't it? The things the human mind does in order to protect itself. You've forgotten all the wonderful times we've had together.
You're lying.
Oh, am I?
Shut up.
Do you remember the look on Mother's face when we tore her apart with the toy knife?
Shut up.
Or the way we sucker punched that idiot skeleton's head off his shoulders when he tried to spare us?
Shut up.
And what about...
Shut up,
You remembered my name. I'm flattered. So, Frisk, let's cut to the chase. I've got places to go and worlds to destroy. But to do that, I'm going to need a body. Yours, of course. You don't have a choice in the matter. I'll either take it from you willingly or by force. So which is it going to be?
Hey, too pacifist, bucko! Unless you got some other squinty-eyed schmuck to possess, you're out of luck.
They're right. You shouldn't be able to possess me. If you were able to do that, then why didn't you try it before now?
I wasn't able to before because my ties to this world were already weak. Even with every ounce of determination in my soul, it's very difficult to stay in this world after death. But then, I was given a very unique opportunity. Ironically, I have that infuriating skeleton Sans to thank. He was so eager to pull his absentee father back into existence that it never occurred to him. When you whip holes in space-time, wandering spirits like me can step right on through. Now I'm fully a part of this world again. I'm like a ghost, but with a far more powerful soul. After that, it was only a matter of biding my time, gathering my strength, planning, and waiting for an opportunity. It was easy without Gaster meddling like he always does. So now, you don't need to kill literally everyone you meet for me to take control of you. I just need to overpower your soul with mine. Easy peasy. So, Frisk, just how determined are you?
Shouldn't have let me catch you monologuing. Kid, you're gonna wish you stayed dead. Hey Frisk, so, Tori says you're grounded. Probably not as grounded as this kid over here is. And by that I mean that I'm probably going to repeatedly slam their face in the ground.
Frisk, listen to us. Sure, all the monsters are amazing fighters, but they also know how to love. Sans loves you. Papyrus loves you. Toriel and Asgore love you. Flowey. Still though, they will aid you. They love you. But they don't. They don't give a crud about you. Ignore this parasite and save Monster Kid. We'll keep the monster occupied. Now go!
Hey, Fritz! Better forget about Car for now. Monster Kid is still in danger. Only one of those priorities has a potential time limit.
Sans, Kid is here. They're trying to get a red echo flower and—
Already know about it, kiddo. Your askers told me everything. The others will be here soon, too. I took a shortcut here. So you hurry up and find Kid, and I'll handle the murder ghost. Don't worry. I'm an old pro at dealing with bad children.
Wanna have a bad time?
What? You think I'm just gonna stand there and take days like these? Kids like you?
Should be burning in hell.
Well, get going, kiddo. What are you waiting for?
You forgot Frisk. About killing every single one of them, down to the smallest malt small. How you'd lure their guard by being so kind, so loving, that the moment they least expected, you'd stab them and watch as they fell to dust.
There's just no way I did those things. This has to be a trick. I would never hurt anyone. There's few things I feel more strongly about than my vow to never harm.
Do you really hate me?
But the memories are flooding back.
But still,
perhaps
I believe in you.
There was a reason I vowed never to harm.
I promise.
I remember it all. But there's just no way
you
I would ever
I'm
be able to bring myself
hope.
To act with such
You're wrong.
Cruelty. But it wasn't just me. I remember being scared. And then there was a voice inside me.
You don't have to be afraid. Let me give you the strength that you need to survive in this cruel world.
And I listened. And I did nothing as it slaughtered everyone.
Good job, kid. You nearly spilled this child's dust over waterfall with your own two hands in another life. And now they might get killed trying to get your attention. How do you atone for that?
I don't think I can. Ever.
Hey, Fisk. You gotta remember that Kara is a demon. A demon can mess with one's soul and mind. The fact that Kara can make you recall all the killing means she was there, inside you, messing with your mind. That's what demons are good at. It might have been your body that killed everyone, but it was never you that did. The fact that you feel bad about it proves that it was not you that did the killing.
But you're wrong. Kara isn't a demon. They're human, just like me. And I could have resisted them at any time. I had so many chances to show mercy. Instead, I watched and told myself, there's nothing I can do. I was a coward.
It's okay, Frisk. You made a mistake. It wasn't you doing those terrible things, it was them. Maybe you remember it, though I hope you don't. But if you do, you have to forgive yourself. You freed everyone. You made everyone
Frisk
so happy.
Under the weight
Never
of
forget
their sins.
That you're amazing and wonderful. Even if you made a mistake. It's okay to make mistakes. You're only
Frisk
human.
Is refusing to forgive themselves.
Frisk! It doesn't matter right now what happened in the past. You have to stay determined to find Monster Kid.
Frisk has lost their determination.
Tra-la-la. This floor is slightly wetter today, but not as wet as it was yesterday.
Hey, Frisk! Is the River Man, River Woman, still in the underground? Maybe you could ask them to get to Kid more quickly. Plus, I have a feeling the River Man's sage advice will help you put your mind at ease for the time being.
Your friends from beyond the wall think I can help you. They are absolutely right.
River Person?
I feel like if you ask the River Person their gender, like, are you a boy or a girl, they'd either say no, yes, or say something that makes no real sense.
Yes.
Hello, Riverman. Can you please take Frisk to the Echoes of Red Petals Grow?
No.
Why not?
Because there are no red echo flowers. It is a myth passed from one fool to another. A myth started by the smartest fool of all. Beware the smart fool and his hands, the color of non-blue stop signs.
If you have a moment, River Person, I'd like an answer to a question. Have you ever encountered the man who speaks in hands?
River Person, how did you know of Gaster, the man who speaks in hands?
River Person, how did you know about W.D. Gaster, and why did you give us a warning about him?
So, the River Person is... I'm wrong about that, because... Tra-la-la.
I have a theory. The River Person... Why'd you warn them of the man who speaks in hands?
Hey, River Person. What do you know about the man who speaks in hands? Should we, beware of them, as you said? Why?
Beware the man who speaks with hands. The man who gained the dark kind of love because he lost the light he had. The man who fell into the dark before he fell into darker dark. Tra-la-la, he's an asshole.
Oh, River Monster Person, do you know why falling into the core caused Gaster to be erased from existence? It just doesn't make sense to me.
Beats me, lol. Probably because science is weird.
So, ta-la-la, house. The River Person doing these days. Tro-lo-lo, I think, more than people thought.
Some of the questions had the words fuzzed out. Does that mean the River Person has the power to block spoilers?
You don't eat spoiled food. Why do you want me to eat spoiled words? So inconsiderate. So I cut the spoiled bits out of your words for you.
Hey, River Person? If you can't take Frisk to a red echo flower, can you just take them to where Kid is? Because Kid believes that red echo flowers are real, and that means Kid is this close to dying!
Yeah, that's kind of why I came here in the first place.
Where do you think we are going? Why are you following me if you don't know where I'm taking you? Do not worry, small human. The monster called Kid is safe. I met him before he tried anything... foolish.
No echo flowers here either! Man, why is romance gotta be so frustrating?
It's because you are wildly chasing the end of the duck-duck.
River Person?
Yes.
I wasn't scared or anything, I just felt like jumping, you know?
Not into the lava, I hope.
No way! I was just looking for a red echo flower so that I can give it to my crush and then they'll think I'm cool and go on dates with me and stuff. But please don't tell my parents that I'm here. Yo, what are you laughing at?
Sorry, I just remembered something funny. You will not find any red echo flowers because they do not exist.
What? Aw, man, I climbed Mount Ebbett for nothing then? But I gotta bring them back something. Or else I'll just look like an idiot.
You wish to be a non-idiot in love. Do you also wish to be a hairless lumberjack? A taste tester with bad taste? A fish made out of cotton candy? Perhaps your beloved would also enjoy a purple echo flower. Those actually do exist, and not in your lava.
Purple echo flowers? I must confess, while I've heard the myth of the red echo flowers, never have I heard of purple echo flowers.
That is because purple echo flowers are the same as blue echo flowers, but they are watered with red water.
And why is the water red?
Magic. And red food dye.
Mr. River Rider, we know.
You know only the title of the book, not its contents, or its lack thereof. The thing that some of you know? It doesn't really matter.
Is Chara still in baby jail?
What are Sans and Kara doing? I hope Sans has everything under control.
Yeah, any way you guys can get here faster? They keep staring at me. It's getting creepy.
Of course. We are already halfway up the mountain. Please just hold on for a bit longer. You know, Sans, I am still not entirely sure I understand what is going on. All you have said is that a murder ghost tried to hurt Frisk before you appeared and trapped them. Why did this ghost try to harm Frisk? I just don't understand.
Go ahead. Tell her that her dead child came back from death just to kill everyone she cares about. I dare you.
Sans?
I don't know. I guess they're just a bit of a crazy ghost, you know?
Well, I'm sure it isn't so simple. I'll have to have a word or two with this ghost.
Yeah, okay.
Sans, thank you so much for your help. Just to know that Frisk is alright. And it must be exhausting to keep that ghost trapped like you're doing.
It's no problem.
Do not be worried, okay? Dr. Alfie says we should reach your location within the next few minutes. So you have to keep the ghost contained until then.
Tori, the ghost is gone.
He had one job! One job!
Oh crap, where did Kara go?
Listen, Tori, I think the ghost will go after Frisk, so I've gotta go now.
Sam, what is going on?
Sorry, no time, bye.
Oh my god, Sans, you piece of trash! You can't get distracted by your one true love while trapping a freaking murderous ghost!
Well, you're not wrong, but you're also not helping.
Wait a minute.
Oh, shit! They're behind you, Sans!
So, Sans, want to have a bad time?
Judging from that last panel, I'm hoping Kara killed Sans rather than do something far worse.
Why you want me dead? Come on, man.
It isn't that I want you dead, it's that I'm afraid Kara did something worse.
The entrance to the underground.
It certainly does bring back memories.
Asgore, now is not the time for nostalgia. There is a dangerous ghost on the loose.
Don't worry, Your Majesty. Ghosts aren't immune to magical spears.
Sans, is that you in there?
Oh no. Are you all right, Sans?
Sans?
Sans? Is everything all right?
We climbed as fast as we could.
Where's the ghost at?
I hope Kara can make the pun-loving skeleton named Sam suffer.
Sans, please say something. You're scaring me.
Tori, run!
What?
Monster Kid acquired a purple echo flower.
This flower is so pretty! I'll definitely convince Frisk that I'm super cool! Unless, it doesn't.
Tra-la-la, we are here. There is the monster called Kid. Safe as a puppy in the hands of someone who really likes puppies.
I'm not ready for this! I'm gonna look stupid in front of Frisk!
Tra-la-la-la-la, don't be shy, everything will be alright. Come on in, kiss the Frisk.
Now I'm hearing voices singing in my head.
Monster Kid, don't forget the Echo Flowers. Well, Echo. Say something romantic into the flower.
Yo, that's a great idea. My mind has gone blank.
Meanwhile, River Person is hardcore shipping the two cinnamon rolls in the background.
Actually, right now I'm shipping the two cinnamon rolls in the foreground. Now I'm shipping the two cinnamon rolls in the background. Just look at those two. They're giving me diabetes. And I don't even have blood. Don't ask how I can blush.
You can let go now?
No.
Why?
I thought you fallen in a pit of lava and died! When you came to my house, I didn't realize you were flirting with me until I thought about it and sulked for a while, but then I thought I should go find you and explain how I actually feel, but then you weren't home, and then Brady and Gaddy said that they had to say that pickup line you used, and then they said something about red echo flowers and how they grew in their lava, and I thought to myself about how you trip all the time, and oh my god, you could have died, and it would have been my fault because I was bad at recognizing a flirt that one time! Why? Why would you be so stupid? Just throwing yourself into danger over a fucking flower!
I wanted you to think I was cool.
I already think you're cool!
What? I'm sorry. What?
Santa's here! Protect Frisk and Kid!
Also, River Person? I really hope you're not just gonna stand there when it's obvious that this new creature has plans to murder your new OVP.
You aren't Sans. You aren't even supposed to be alive, current dreamer. Who are you? It doesn't matter.
You've been awfully quiet down there. What? No witty remarks? Come on, Sans. You've always been good at making me laugh. Really? Nothing to say at all? Are you going to cooperate with me then? Wonderful. Why don't you tell me all about this river person then? You know something about them.
You.
Oh, language. And in front of a child, too. Whatever would Toriel say?
You. She was your mother. What kind of demon kills their own mother?
The kind you would let possess your body, apparently. Now, as fun as it is to torment you, we don't have time for this. Tell me what you know about this river person. They're attacking us, and I'd rather keep your body alive a while longer. So talk.
Do you honestly think I care if I die at this point? Especially if I'm taking you with me.
Oh, I won't die. I just hop out of your corpse.
I'm still not helping you.
I can't believe my ass got built, Toriel!
If it wasn't what you wanted, then why did you say it in the first place? I see you're still hiding behind your Anon mask, too. Such a weakling.
I think it would be wise of you to perhaps leave forever. If you do not,
then I shall make you leave.
It will not be very fun for you.
Kara checks the river person's stats. The River Reaper. Attack.
What?
Defense.
What? Determined to protect the ones they love?
Sams needs to keep moving since it seems the river person does orange attacks.
They're right. La la la. How long can you keep moving? Let's dance, naughty little child.
Dude, what the? Brisk, I think I want to go home now.
But Sans.
Sans tried to kill us. How screwed up is that?
But it's not really Sans. Didn't you hear what the river person said?
Not really. Kind of distracted by the fact that Sans just tried to kill us.
Listen, earlier Sans told me that my mom and the others are on their way here, so...
Listen closely, Frisk.
Kara, you son, daughter of a female dog, how dare you? How dare you? Starts foaming at the mouth with anger.
Do you hear them?
And just like always, it begins with Toriel.
Tori?
Listen beyond the world to the hunting.
All these Anons are just posting and giving bad ideas and not having the balls to not hide behind that Anon button like they don't want to be blamed or kink
shamed. Sansa's face is torture. Oh my god, I can't even, I won't sleep tonight.
No! Mom! This is all a bad dream. Come you to fucking hell, Kara.
I would have been fine if Sansa died. I would have been completely fine with that, but you just had to go and kill Goat Mom. You had to have her dead for your writing, and as an author, I love it, but god damn you.
I would have been fine with dying instead, too.
Don't give up hope, Sans. Your warning was probably enough for Tori to brace herself for Kara's attack. Everyone is probably helping her recover right now.
I admire your optimism, but... to be honest, I've always had a hard time staying that positive. I mean, why do you think I tell so many jokes?
Oh, and Sans, I'm really sorry. You couldn't save Toriel in any way. For everything you've been through, you didn't deserve to have this tragedy. But there is someone you can save. Someone you can save. Someone who saved you when the world was close to an end. Reach out for their name. It's what Toriel wanted.
Good God, my English is dumb! If not, then my paranoia is dumb! I'm dumb!
Frisk. I owe that kid everything. Kara was relentless. They died so many times, only to reset seconds later. And all they had to do was defeat me once. Then, game over. Survive this, and I'll show you my special attack. At the time, I didn't realize that this kid was being possessed by Kara. In retrospect, maybe I should have picked up on some of the signs that this kid might be slightly more demon-y than humans are supposed to be. It wasn't till the very end that I actually met the real Frisk. Alright. That's it. No more funny business. Time for my special attack. Are you ready? Here goes nothing.
Cheating me, loving bunny bastard!
That's it. It's literally nothing. And it's not going to be anything either. You get it? So I waited. I was ready to wait forever if I had to. but I underestimated that kid's patience, and they caught me off guard. Did you really think you would be able to...
No!
What are you...
I'm stopping you.
Dad!
What the hell is going on?
What the hell is going on?
You done strolling down memory lane? Now hurry up and tell me about the river person before they slice us in half.
I'll tell you what I know, but listen closely, because I'm only saying this once.
According to all known laws of aviation, there's no way a bee should be able to fly. Its wings are too small to get off its fat little body off the ground. Bee, of course, flies anyway because bees don't care what humans think is possible. Yellow black.
Seriously?
Check it out. Barry, breakfast is ready. Oh, me. Come on, Sam. Hello, Barry, Adam, can you believe this is happening? I can't, I'll pick you up.
I can't hear you.
Good money for those. Sorry, I'm excited. Just the graduate. We're very proud, so. Perfect report card opens. We're very proud. Mom, I got a thing going here. You got land on your foot. Oh, that's me. Wave to us. We'll be in row 180.
You're really starting to piss me off, you obnoxious bag of...
Oats? You know, kid, you're a real Kara sight.
What do you think you're doing?
What do you think I'm doing? Obviously, I'm stopping you.
You're stupid! You'll die, and I'll just leave your body to possess someone else!
That ain't happening. Do you really think I'm just gonna let you leave this body? No, kid. You're gonna stay right here with me for the rest of our lives. Which probably won't be very long, if she has anything to say about it.
My soul is stronger! I'll break free!
I don't have to hold you very long. It just takes one good, solid hit.
What? How much HP do you have?
One?
What?
Must be pretty embarrassing for you, considering how much you died to me.
You idiot! Move! I don't want to die!
I imagine most of the people you killed last timeline felt the same way. It's better if you just accept the inevitable. You're gonna burn in hell, kid.
Even if I have to drag you there myself.
Get ready to die? I didn't think this far ahead.
You're kidding, right? River person didn't think that part out?
Well, no, I didn't think he would just stop. I thought he'd pass out from exertion.
River man, woman, person, come on, there has to be something you can do. Maybe put Kara into a bottle?
No, I'm not a scientist or anything, but I'm pretty sure that wouldn't work. It'd at least have to be a magic bottle.
River person, what are you doing? Kill them! Words later!
No, words now. Because I will not harm Sand.
Oh my god, river person! Kill them! Do it now! Strike them down with all your might!
I will not. Stop asking me to kill Sand. You people are horrible!
River person, for the love of god! He's literally giving you a chance to banish his demon child to hell! How much thinking does this require?
I will not kill my own son, you sicko!
Tra-la-la, something, I'm mysterious. Nope.
Well, awkward.
You! She's your mom?
I knew it.
Wait, how could you possibly have known?
It's sort of obvious. There's her voice, for one. Also, she uses a fire scythe, and I remembered my mom could do that and-
Herman, don't you realize? Sans wants you to strike him down. I know it's hard, but it's for the greater good. Think of the lives Kara's already taken. If you don't stop them now, things could end up even worse.
You sound like Wingding. No.
I do not believe in doing evil things for the greater good. It's gross.
Oh my.
So, you can't hurt Sans then. But I can hurt you.
This is going to be very...
Trying to take my brother's body using your evil powers? You underhanded devil! You need to apologize immediately!
The Great Papyrus. Attack 8, Defense 2. How did he get here so fast?
You better believe we're about to open a fresh can of whoop-ass on you!
Undyne, attack 7, defense 0. She's wearing a Santa coat for some reason?
You've been a very bad child, haven't you? Time to be punished.
Metaton EX, attack 8, defense 1. Glitter? I'm here too. X Royal Scientist Alphys, attack 1, defense 3. Nerd. Flowey, the flower, attack 19, defense 0. Abomination in the shape of a flower.
Kara, we know you are in there. You are in so much trouble.
King Asshole Dreamer, attack 80, defense 80. Dad.
Oh, good. We weren't torn asunder from the teleportation. What a relief.
Dr. Winding Yester, attack 66, defense 66. And then there's this asshole.
You made a huge mistake messing with one of my friends, kid!
We have you surrounded! Surrender my brother this instant!
Idiots! You idiots!
You are nothing to me! You can't bring yourselves to harm your precious friend! You can't even touch me!
I'm very disappointed in you, my child. I never thought you would go so far. Queen Toriel, attack 80, defense 80. Not as easy to kill as one might think.
You cannot give up just yet. Dr. Gaster, how are you two doing?
That attack was rather sudden. I can move what she was able to steal herself, otherwise.
No! She has to wake up!
Don't worry, you got this, Papyrus.
Toriel, please. Wake up.
See? There! It's working!
Her Majesty is alive! You did well, Papyrus. Excellent work, my son.
Well done, Pappy!
Yeah, you made that healing spell your bit nasty!
I, the Great Papyrus, refuse to fail at anything! If anyone could perform first aid magic with no prior training, it would be me!
Sand, where is he? The ghost has possessed him! He's in grave danger and—
Toriel, please, no sudden movements.
She's right, though. The ghost has somehow possessed Sans' body, even though a ghost shouldn't be able to do that. Ghosts are supposed to be incapable of possessing something that already has a soul. If I hadn't observed it firsthand, I wouldn't have believed it to be possible.
But why would anyone ever want to attack Sans? Who is this ghastly ghost?
I am uncertain, but it must have obtained power from somewhere in order to overpower another soul as it is doing. But where it would have gotten such a substantial...
It's Kara.
Oh my god!
Kara!
I have no idea who this person is.
Oh dear.
Isn't that the first human
But
who...
Flowey, even if that were true, why would Kara attack Toriel? That doesn't seem like something they would do at all.
Then maybe you don't know them as well as you think you do.
We can't waste any more time. If we don't do something, Sans might be forced to hurt Frisk. We must...
I understand. We will go and deal with Sans, but please stay here and rest. I don't want to see you hurt again.
Asgore, I am fine.
I agree with Asgore, Your Majesty. It would be foolish to strain your body after taking an attack like that.
Thank you for your concern, but I am perfectly fine. My children are in danger, and I will not sit by idly and watch them put themselves and others in harm's way.
I don't care who they are! They got Sans! Even if they were a literal sugar plum fairy, it wouldn't stop me from beating the ever-loving crap out of them! Nobody gets away with possessing one of my friends without receiving a serving of the freaking cosmic knuckle sandwich and magical spear prize combo that I'm about to serve!
Heh, good luck with that. You don't even know where they took the stupid smiley trash bag.
Hey guys, River Person just met up with Frisk and they're going to Waterfall to find Monster Kid. Someone needs to find them while Sans holds them off.
Guster, tell everyone that Frisk and Kid are in Waterfall! We'll try and distract that murdered ghost!
Asgore, Frisk gonna find his bay in Waterfall. Better go help her.
Sweet! Now we know where they are. Let's kick some ghost booty!
Wait, Undyne. We'll never catch up to them just by running. Not all of us are in as great of shape as you.
I'll carry you all myself if I have to! Come on!
There has to be a faster way to reach Waterfall. Time is of the essence.
Dad, can you teleport? I know Sans said it was a family thing.
Well, yes, but...
Oh, that is perfect!
What are we waiting for? Hurry up and punch a hole into space so I can punch a ghost in the face! With spears!
Is there a problem, Dr. Gaster?
I do not think it would be wise to put all of you at risk.
What? That's not a good enough reason! Sans is at risk! Risk is at risk!
It may cause irreparable damage to the space-time continuum. We could end up in an alternate universe, we could end up trapped for all eternity in the void, What if by teleporting, I am merely creating copies of us in new location, while simultaneously deconstructing our original forms?
What if Frisk is already lying on the cold, hard ground, bleeding, gasping, as we speak? What if they are right now? At this very moment, choking on their own blood and breathing their last breath, uttering the words, "If only Gaster were to have teleported, I would still be alive. This was so preventable. But now, I die thanks to you. W.D. Gaster. What say of you, then? Would you deprive the poor child of a chance at life? What kind of monster are you?
Dad, Metaton is right. We don't have time to be afraid. I am confident that you can do this.
All right. Gather around.
Wait, if Sans only has 1 HP and he got hit by Toriel, did he die? I hope not, because that might hurt Kara, and then she'll have to find another host.
Oh, there's no need to worry about Sans. That was a love tap. I have no intention of hurting anyone.
Will Toriel finally scold Frisk for using the F word?
What? Frisk? Who taught you that word?
Mom! I'm so glad you're okay!
Mommy got me, you little...
Because I know she might dance away at the first sign of the battle ending, and there's a lot that needs explaining. Gaster! Before you pass out from teleporting so many monsters, you mind trapping that weirdo in the cloak?
Huh? The Askers have betrayed me.
What weirdo? Oh,
You're the river person, aren't you? You seem oddly familiar.
New phone. Who dis?
Hey, do we know one another?
No, I have no idea who you are, Dr. Mysterious Science Man.
Okay.
Greetings, Mother. I see that I failed to kill you.
Kara, leave Sen's body. Now.
Or what? You shoot harmless fireballs at me? But guess what, Mother? This isn't harmless. Yeah, go Tori! Kick my ass!
There's nothing Kara can do to get out of this. The others can just tire Sans out with their love taps and dodge Kara's attacks. The only way I can see them getting out of this to get the others to back off is to hurt Sans' soul themselves. That is an interesting question, though. What happens to a monster's soul inside a perfectly healthy body when it dies? Does the body disappear, or does it just kind of exist out of time like Gaster did? Oh no, I should not have said that. Ignore this comment.
Uh-huh.
I'm so sorry.
What?
He, looks kind of dead, darling.
Oh, Sans, get up this instant!
Toriel, you sure that was just a love tap?
Yes, I'm sure. I don't know what went wrong.
This may not be as bad as it looks. Perhaps he is fighting back. Yes, I'm certain of this. Sans is very strong. Surely he can overcome a mere child.
Bullshit.
You're a liar. A dirty, sciencey liar. You and your fancy words. It's a mask to hide your stupid,
dumb, ugly, true, evil, mad scientist face. I know what you've done, Wing Ding. You couldn't care less if your own son lived or died. You jerk!
You know, Flowey, there's something I don't quite understand. How did you know Kara was the cause of all this?
You're really going to start asking me dumb questions like that when Sans could literally be dead on the ground right now? Sheesh. And here I thought you people cared about each other or something.
Well, they're green now, so at least if this is a trick, it's not gonna work.
Say, Metaton, couldn't you just fly into Sans' body in your ghostly form to see what's going on?
Well, I suppose I could. I do hate leaving my body, but I suppose this is a bit of an emergency.
Hang on, Sans. Please.
How is this possible? My love, you're alive.
Am I? A mother should love her children. I can only pretend. And it's your fault, Wing Ding. Don't you remember? You're the reason I'm like this. I was one of your first experiments. So now, I'm a soulless husk made of dust and determination. Just like that flower over there. So yeah, thanks a lot, Gastard.
River person, I understand why you're mad with Gaster. But what he did was on good intentions. He wanted to save the skeleton he loved. Yes, he did a mistake. Okay, a lot of mistakes. And yes, he can be a little insensible sometimes, but come on, he's not all that bad, is he?
Oh, buddy. That wasn't even close to the worst he's done. Shall I elaborate, Wing Ding?
Stop, please.
Do you know where he got the determination that he injected in me? I died because a human child shot me by accident. But he didn't care that it was an accident. He murdered the child in cold blood. Then after my experiment seemed to fail, he moved on to murdering criminals for his stupid science. And after that, he took to experimenting on captured humans before sending their souls to Asgore. And as if that wasn't bad enough on its own, all the while he neglected our sons. Always he was busy. He had important things to do. Sans was forced to grow up faster than he should have.
Lumpy Bunny learned he had been home all along.
Even still, he still had hope that one day his dad would look up and notice him again. Can you even imagine what it must have been like when he learned what his own father's experiments really were? So, Wingding, what greater good were you working towards? Tell me all about your good intentions. Tell me how they make all of this suddenly okay. I dare you.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
That's not what I expected him to do.
I have no excuse. I thought... I wanted to. I told myself that if I worked hard enough, that maybe if... I don't know anymore.
I'm sorry, but I can't be on your side. Gaster, in a rage, killed the human who killed his love. Yes, it wasn't right, but he obviously wasn't thinking clearly. Then he tried to bring you back, to your kids, to him. He experimented on criminals. Well, yes, that's wrong. They're not innocents. The closest thing to innocence he experimented with were the humans who were going to die by the Royal Guard. After all that, then he sent to the void, ripped from existence. Why are you right to yell at him?
Don't make excuses for me. Stop making excuses. My actions were inexcusable. So many died by my hand. Tortured more than that. Monsters, humans, children, guilty and innocent. There is no justification for that.
And so, the deaths of the damned and the innocent weigh heavily upon the shoulders of the desperate and deranged, now that his eyes have been forcibly reopened by the Angel of Vengeance, both horrible and enlightening, laying the scene before him. Will he finally become mad from the stains on his hands? Or will this angel, acting as judge and jury, grant him mercy and time's love?
Am I the only one who thinks Gaster didn't accidentally fall, but rather willingly fell, if you catch my meaning?
That's not what you expected him to do? His long-dead wife, who he loved more than anything, comes back only to tell him what he's been telling himself for years? And you expected him to do anything else but cry? Don't you ever wonder how a genius could fall accidentally into his own creation, which he designed himself? Maybe it was too much for him. Maybe he told himself that his sons would be better off without him. Maybe he jumped.
That never even occurred to me. I thought he'd turned evil or something? Okay, that sounds really dumb when I say it out loud. Man, what in the fresh hecklers did I expect? You done goofed, Herman! What, did you expect him to be all... Oh, yes, you have seen to my black and emo heart. All this time, I have been a cartoon villain with no redeeming qualities or feelings aside from malice and evil. Watch as I kick this puppy for no reason. Gasp as I construct a death ray to destroy everything. Because I'm evil. Why are you laughing? And crying?
I'm sorry. It's just... I missed you.
Oh, yes. Swan dive! Wow. Someone really needs to clean up in here. Hello there. You'd better get out of Sands right now, or...
Metaton? Can't say I expected this. But you know, it's actually pretty convenient this way.
Convenient? How?
You can send a message to the others. Tell them that I'll only leave Sands if Frisk willingly gives me their body.
I see. You're making demands then, and Sans is your hostage. I don't think that's going to work out the way you think it will, kid, because...
I also want you to tell them exactly what I'm doing to Sans. I've forced his soul into the darkest parts of his memories. Essentially, I'm forcing him to relive the worst parts of his memories over and over and over.
Listen, Kara can't run while our souls are green. Tell them to finish us off.
You don't get it, do you? They aren't going to hurt you, no matter what it personally costs to them. Pretty sad. Especially since you seem to have no problem watching your loved ones die in front of you. Speaking of which, why don't you get back to doing that for a while? I wonder how long it'll take before your mind breaks.
I have returned with terrible news.
What terrible news?
Darlings, it was just awful. How do I even begin? Everything was in complete disarray. The whole place is just flooded with that awful child's influence. They're keeping Sans as a sort of hostage, locked away in a prison of his own nightmares. It's awful. Dreadful, even.
Well, what does Kara want?
They want you, Frisk.
Wait, what?
Well, your body, specifically. They say that they'll trade Sans for you.
I have to ask, Kara, why go through all this trouble to possess Frisk specifically? Wouldn't it be better to possess a powerful monster like Toriel or Asgore? Or better yet, make Alphys build you a mechanical body so you don't have to go through the trouble of possessing anyone?
Tch, monsters are weak. I don't want a monster's body. It was always my plan to take Frisk's body. They're powerful. They defeated Azrael, even when he became a god. I will need that kind of power in order to destroy everything.
While killing is fun for a while, the greatest pleasure is to rule over the cattle and put discord over them while you play yourself up as the messiah, never knowing that it was you all along who brought the suffering over them. It never gets old to see the fools in conflict with each other, hurting themselves over petty matters like race, religion, political fractions, and ideas alike. To destroy everything is only fleeting, but to make them eternally suffer is the greatest reward.
Tempting, but I think I'll pass. The world isn't a toy for me to play with. The world is disgusting. Needs to die.
Hey, Flowey, why have you just been sitting there and letting Kara torment Frisk's friends? Too afraid to hurt your best friend? You idiot! Next time, don't trust people. It's better that way. I thought you knew.
In this world, it's kill or be killed.
You shut the f*** up. You don't know anything.
Kara might be underestimating Sansa's ability to withstand reliving bad memories. Flowey did a lot of things as a flower before Frisk came along and usurped his ability to save.
It's not the most comfortable situation, but yeah, I've definitely had worse. Should have known I'd end up like this if I tried to fight back. What was even the point?
Gaster, I know thinking about the mad scientist stuff probably isn't nice, but I think it's time to think about mad scientist void monster stuff. Kara said you interfered before. I think it's time you stepped up to bat. I don't think it's just Sans that can dunk someone.
No, I dare not. Void powers are destructive by nature, and I'd be just as likely to irreversibly harm Sans as I would be to do anything actually helpful. The times I intervened in the Void were merely to distract Kara and give Frisk a chance to break free of their influence.
What are you talking about? Frisk has never been possessed by anyone.
Oh, yes, of course. I must have misspoke.
I may not know what you're talking about, but I can tell that you're definitely full of crap.
Full of crap is his default state. Gaster didn't misspeak. Kara possessed me once. In the timeline before this one.
You remember?
Involved in this. Oh my god. That's never a good sign!
What? Timeline? Frisk, what are you talking about?
Think really hard. You might remember it a little bit. In that timeline, you stood up against me, kid. And when I tried to kill you, Undyne shielded you with her body.
What are you talking about? That's not what... Oh.
And that's only one of the things I did. That Kara and I did. Everyone in the underground that we met. We left a trail of dust in our wake from the ruins all the way to New Home. Nobody even stood a chance. Because whenever we died, we could simply turn back time with the power of our determination. We would travel from place to place, hunting down monsters until the entire area was devoid of life. And by journey's end, we had reached LV-19. We were unstoppable. But then Sans stood in our way. Sans, he knew about our ability. Each time he killed us, he'd say something like,
"Yeah, oh, that expression,
I was so cool.
That's the expression of someone who's died blah blah times. You can't understand how this feels. Knowing that one day, without any warning, it's all going to be reset. All I know is, seeing what comes next, I can't afford not to care anymore.
Sans, I didn't know."
He knew full well that all we had to do was defeat him once, and then we'd be powerful enough to destroy everything. But he kept fighting. Even though it was a completely hopeless fight, he still fought. Even though we'd killed almost everyone he knew, he still fought. And then I started to think, I'd been telling myself, this is the only way. I have no choice. I just want to see what happens and then I'll go back. Yet, here he was, fighting an unwinnable battle with all of his strength because it was the right thing to do. I was ashamed of myself, but more than that, I started to root for him. I didn't want Kara to win, but eventually, Kara caught him off guard. I couldn't let it end like that. Because of Sans, I was able to fight back. I was able to reset back to the day I fell and do things the right way.
Sans, can you hear me in there? You haven't kicked Kara out of your body yet.
So I'm guessing you're starting to lose hope.
That's the only rational explanation for why you haven't dumped this loser into another dimension.
We believe in you, Sans. We all do. And if you don't believe me, just listen past the fourth wall.
I think Kara tormenting Sans is a lot like shaking a wasp's nest in a jar. That jar's gonna open, and then...
Don't give up, my friend!
determined for Frisk.
What was the point? The point is that there's people who need you, Sans, whether you like it or not. You cannot just roll over and let things happen anymore, or people will get hurt. People you care about. People you love. I can forgive you for forgetting this because of what Kara is putting you
Sans,
through, but...
Sans! The point was to protect your friends! You. Stay determined, Sans!
It's your soul, Sans. Are you really gonna let a pipsqueak, bratty little kid with some severe mental issues push you
The
back?
Point of fighting back was to help save your friends, Sans. If you hadn't held control for so long enough to warn Toriel of Kara's attack, she would have easily died. If you hadn't made it so hard for Kara to harm others, they would have killed
Sans, don't give up. Your friends are always beside you, and I am too. We all are. You can overcome this. We believe in you. Your friends are trying
Sans,
to save
the point
you
was
right
that
now.
If you fight back, the world would be much safer.
If, you've been through
if you fight back, Kara wouldn't kill. So many innocent lives would be saved. There's
Sans,
always a point to
do
fight
you know
back.
Why you fight back? Because you have a lot of things you want to protect. Your friends, your brothers,
Sans,
and your life.
Can you hear me?
Sans,
listen, you can't give
Sans,
up. Everyone is waiting
remember.
For you. You have to keep fighting. For them and yourself. Stay determined.
Remember? Because came back stronger than ever. Everything with a bad side always has a good
Sans, please fight back. I believe in you, Sans.
There's a lot of people out there who believe in you, Sans. You've just got to believe in you. You know? I hope that made sense.
Yeah, kid. It's starting to.
So, Kara, partner, got any plans to get out of this mess? After all, Sans seems to be pretty well adjusted to normal mind torture, such as seeing his friends die. We have a few choices. Ramp up the pain we deliver Sans and bring him to the point of death, and give Frisk a set time to give up their body, or call for everyone else to leave except Frisk, so no one gets a jump on you while you're transitioning from body to body. Or have you something you could do?
Watch out, Kara. You about to taste the rainbow of friendship, motherfucker.
Hey, Kara. I don't know if you'll ever hear this, but I'll try anyway. I don't believe that you really hate the whole world. Back then, all the way back then, Toriel, Asgore, and Asriel accepted you, right? They had no reason to. You were a human. One of those who trapped every monster in the underground. Yet they still accepted you. Weren't you, Kara, the hope of the entire underground at one point? I don't think all monsters would call you that if you really were pure evil. I refused to believe that. And more importantly, weren't you happy back then? I have no idea what pain you've been through, but... Kara, do you really think that this world doesn't at least...
No, it doesn't! If you think the world has anything worthwhile in it, then all that means is that you're as stupid and naive as I used to be. Humanity is cruel and disgusting, and monsters are weak and cowardly. My family never loved me. They were afraid of me. Even Asriel. I don't need help from any of you. Leave me alone.
Some. You once told me that you were gonna troll me. All the Anons wishing that I was dead. You were looking kinda stressed with your knife lodged in your chest. So it's time you got out of my head. Welp,
The memes start coming and they don't stop coming. Can you handle it when I hit the ground punning? You thought you had me, kid, but that ship is sunk. Your mouth is smart, but you're about to get dunked. So much for you, so many memes. I'm gonna fill hell with your damn screams. You'll never laugh if you don't lol. You'll never flame if you don't troll. Hey now, I'm the meme lord. Wanna go, kid? Let's play. Hey now, look at my sword. Show is over, get slayed. Your whole shtick's getting old. Only 90s kids get Rickrolled. It's a dark place, but it's gonna get brighter. What, are you scared, you little ankle biter? I remember when you killed my brother. Guess it's not surprising that you'd stab your own mother. Your chances now are looking pretty slim. You're in deep shit now, hope you know how to swim. My swag is turned, how about you? I'm a lead hacker and you're just a noob.
Those moves, though.
The fuck?
I am confused by this.
Don't you see? You were right, Winding. He's fighting back.
But how? And why is he shooting rainbows from his eye sockets? This is concerning.
I think I may have an explanation for that. According to what I'm seeing on my spectral analysis app, Sans appears to be, well, he appears to have weaponized his imagination against the invading spirit. It's, how do I even describe this? Just come over and see. I don't know how, but this magical energy levels are exponentially higher than they were a few minutes ago.
Shoes. What?
What are those?
Oh my.
Sans, you crazy dork! That's so freaking cool!
Yeah, never in my life have I simultaneously felt this much secondhand embarrassment and pride.
What I find most interesting is how his soul seems to be drawing in power from around him. I think this is how he's able to fight Kara effectively despite being the weaker of the two souls. But just where is he drawing all of this power from in the first place?
It's from the Askers and from ourselves. He must be drawing power from the links between his soul and the souls of those supporting him.
Somebody please ask!
What, you tired of my sass?
I need to get myself away from this place.
You're correct. What a concept. I'm getting tired of you myself, and we could all use some head space. Well, the memes start coming and they don't stop coming. Can you handle it when I hit the ground punning? You thought you had me, kid, but the ship is sunk. Your mouth is smart, but you're about to get dunked. So much for you, so many memes. I've got enough to fill hell with your damn screams. You'll never laugh if you don't laugh. You'll never flame if you don't.
Stop! Don't kill Kara! Kara!
Frisk, why didn't you let Sans kill Kara? I mean, Kara's just gonna come back.
I'm sorry, Frisk. You want to repeat that for me? I think you said something about not killing Kara. It must be a mistake on my part. There's no way, after all they've done, that you wouldn't let Sans mean that murder baby to death.
I've said it before and I'll say it again. I vowed to never harm anyone. And if I let Kara be killed in front of me without saying anything about it, it'd be as good as me killing them myself. Trust me, I'd know.
Sans, are you okay?
Well, I sort of feel like I was, sucked through a wormhole and then spat out into a volcano or something and then run over by like 40-something trains carrying armed bombs full of stupid bullshit. Wait. I can think of a better metaphor for how shockingly horrible I feel. Okay, so imagine, like, an eldritch fucking fairy godmother ascends from bullshit fairyland. She sprinkles magic fairy glitter on me, causing every bone in my body to shatter. Then she lovingly hand-stitches each shard together using barbed wire and hot sauce before shoving me into a, wait, what were those spiky torture coffins called again?
You mean an Iron Maiden?
Yeah, that.
So like an Iron Maiden on wheels. Then the souls of the damned screamed out in a chorus of "What's new, pussycat?" as I'm being pulled down into the darkest pits of hell where some jackass prince is waiting for me with a smug entitled grin on his face. He's like, "Let's dance, motherfucker," and I'm violently pulled onto the dance floor. For some reason, my face is melting and I can't say no, so I'm forced to endure his company. And then we drop it like it's hot and I start beatboxing aggressively to hide the shame. He then proceeds to drag me down into some freaky horror dungeon, and at this point, I can't even tell if I'm real or a figment of my own imagination. Then the dude turns into literal Satan and starts stroking some sort of contract and says, "Signing your name in blood would really turn me on," and then stabbing occurs.
Stabbing? You mean like this? Hey, Sans, you're looking kind of stressed with my knife inside your chest.
Knife one, kid.
Sans! Gotcha! Yeah, it's a good thing I was here to get you, brother, or else that may have ended in tragedy. Sans? This isn't funny. This is not the time to be napping, Sans! Sans, please, wake up!
Kara, please, wake up. I don't like this plan anymore.
Papyrus is gonna wreck some shit!
Yo! How could you? Why?
Papyrus, I'm so sorry, but he's gone.
Well, Frisk, what was that thing about letting it happen right in front of you? I must have forgotten. Please do repeat yourself.
But I didn't want...
Those who fight monsters may also become monsters, but those who let them roam free are no better than willing accomplices. Or in other words, congratulations on signing Sans' death warrant, Frisk!
I didn't want this! I just didn't want Kara to... Oh, God!
Frisk, I hate to say this, but... it's really your fault that this happened to Sans. How do you feel?!
Mysterious voice from the beyond! It wasn't Frisk's fault! What's with all of you blaming Frisk for something Kara did? Frisk is amazing and kind and wants to save everyone! Even bad people like Kara! That isn't a bad thing! I have no idea why I've even been listening to you guys! You're a bunch of dumb, smelly turds!
Well, to be fair, they did kind of warn me about the thing. With Frisk that, one time, and the, nice things, and with the memes and stuff.
Yo?
That was very... yeah. Oh, I am in so much pain, guys.
Sans! But, how is this possible?
It's possible, because he's a damn dirty liar.
Bring. Hello? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see. I'll tell him. It's for you, Flowey the Flower. It's the kettle. He says you're black.
Wait just a moment.
Is something wrong?
Oh. Of course.
The knife would not have hit any of your bones. And even if it had, it was silly of me to think skeletons could bleed. I should have known better.
Sans, what's your favorite color? I know you're dying, but this is important.
I don't know. Purple's cool, I guess?
No puedo creerlo. Mi hijo pequeño es salvado por la salsa de tomate.
I've never been so happy to see a ketchup stain on a shirt.
Sans! Sans, you're alright! Oh, I'm so sorry. This is all my fault. I didn't mean to hurt you. I didn't mean to hurt anyone. I was so scared.
What are you talking about, kiddo? I'm the one who, hurt people today. What with the whole being possessed thing.
No, I mean...
Oh! Frisk, no, I don't blame you for any of that. I mean, I'd kind of have to be the world's biggest hypocrite to blame you after... After what Kara made me. Not that I blamed you before either. Well, maybe I did at first, but... Frisk, listen to me. Back then, I'd lost hope. You saved me. And now you've saved me again. I mean, sheesh, kid. You're some kind of hero or something, and here you are trying to apologize to me. That's kind of dumb. Quit saying dumb stuff, okay? There isn't a single person here who doesn't love you to pieces. Except Flowey, I guess, but he'd probably love you too if he could.
Don't put words in my mouth, Jack! Jerk face!
Tell me I'm wrong, then. Thought so.
Good job, Sans. You've ripped your brother's heart to pieces and stomped them into the ground. Nice.
Sans!
Yeah, bro?
Sans, I want you to listen to me carefully. You are absolutely forbidden to ever pull a stunt like this ever again because it isn't funny in the slightest.
Papyrus, I'm sorry.
You had better be sorry!
I know. I'm really sorry.
Oh my god, I'm so glad you're alright.
Yeah.
Tell me Mrs. Herman Gaster is coming home with everyone!
Tra-la-la. Home is where the heart is. My heart is gone. I can never go home.
So, Sans, how does it feel to almost be undressed by Toriel?
It felt like how I almost answered this question, but then decided not to. Lol.
Hammond, don't you dare live!
It is better this way.
Herman, stop being emo. You clearly have your feelings back.
I am an actress. I remember what it was like to have a soul. And rather than facing the bleakness of reality, I instead choose to act as if I have a soul. Sometimes, I even fool myself.
Drama, what a pathetic creature.
Ring-a-ding, wing-ding, Gaster. Someone is trying to sail off. I suggest trying to talk to her at least.
Chloe, I think you should have a talk with Herman. I mean, you don't have a heart, but you have a home.
Why would I want to talk to her? You're not the boss of me.
My love, please don't leave.
Let it go, wing-dingus.
I don't care if you don't want to forgive me. Just please, stay with us. Papyrus hasn't even really met you yet.
And he never will, because his mother died a long time ago.
The river person's my mom?
Well, yeah, bro. Obviously.
I didn't know.
I hate teleportation, but... I can't lose her! Crap.
Winding! ¿Por qué mi marido un burro erótico ignorante es estúpido tales?
Gaster, you nailed that teleport.
Oh, ha ha. It's a good thing skeletons don't need to breathe, I suppose.
Please, Wingdings, tell me that the water isn't filled with piranha.
It appears that there are, in fact, piranha in this river. But that is fine. I don't smell like oranges, so...
Would you like some tea, Dr. Gaster? It's got cream and oranges in it, and has a nice scent.
I see no possible way this could negatively impact me in the future.
No, please! God! Not there! The teeth are so sharp!
Herman! Act! Save Klutz of a husband!
Oye! Nadie is the computer! Puro Melosia!
It's not fair!
So, Wingdingus, what did we learn today?
Yes, Wingdingus. What did we learn?
Don't swim after drinking orange tea.
Anything else you'd like to add? What are you laughing about now, you weirdo?
You still love me.
You always were a very smart fool. How can a soulless creature feel love?
Oh, please! If you're soulless, then I'm the fucking queen of the fairies! Soulless creatures like me can only feel two things. Basic survival instinct and the satisfaction of defeating someone in Smash Bros. But you like dived into a bunch of piranhas just now. That's incredibly stupid. There's no way I'd do that for anyone. Now I don't know why you have a soul when I don't. But clearly you do, you stupid river bitch.
Flowey, while I do appreciate the support, can you not call my wife such rude things? It's distasteful.
I have a soul? But I would have known if my soul had come back somehow, right?
You're a method, actress. You've been playing the soulless creature so long that you've tricked even yourself into believing it. That's my hypothesis, at any rate.
No, that... That would mean... Do you mean to say that all this time I've been avoiding my family for no reason? Have I been making up excuses for myself then? My sons were all on their own for all these years while I puttered around the river feeling sorry for myself? And how would I even know for certain that what you're saying is true?
Well, for one, I wouldn't be able to reach out to you like this if you had no soul. Also, your actions today have been rather selfless in nature. Listen, please come to the surface with us. It would mean so much to our sons. And to me. I mean, it's your choice what you want to do now, but I just want you to know that...
Poor Flowey, though. Imagine how disappointed he must feel at not having a soulless buddy and eternally being forever alone.
You people just don't get it! I'm soulless! I don't care! I can't care! I'm incapable of caring! What would I want a buddy for? Especially one who's soulless. Why would I wish for that on someone? I may be soulless, but I'm not... evil. Or maybe I am. I don't know. Today sucks in so many ways.
Hey, Flowey. We should play Smash Bros. After we've gotten some sleep, okay?
Okay. Yeah. Thanks, Frisk.
I got you, bro.
Completely irrelevant, curious question. Who does Flowey main in Smash?
I main as Mega Man! I kind of like projectile attacks, in case you hadn't noticed. Friendliness pellets.
Hey, Frisk and Kid. You two were doing something before Sans appeared. Why won't you finish it?
No! Wink!
Yay! Now the whole family is together again! Time to wrap this quest up with a group hug, a kiss between Frisk and Kid, and then everyone can go back home for some of Tori's butterscotch pie.
Fluffy bunny tail.
Yep! What could possibly go wrong?
Tori.
Okay, so Gaston and Herman are back together. Sans is a meme lord, Frisk and Kid are a thing. Yay for super happy fun times. Now hurry up and get to the bad part. What's going to happen? Is Char going to come back? Is Flowey going to do something? Will Jerry make an appearance? Fill me up, mate, with a juicy sneak peek.
Car, I saw your face. You didn't feel sad, did you? I thought that our plan was to erase their existence alongside with their world. Or our relentless killer, the merciless demon, decided to rethink our entire plan, just like Flowey did. Well, do whatever you want, but don't forget the reason we destroyed Flower. Now, if you are still with us, go and haunt the monster kid. Frisk would love to make a trade for that.
I am too weak to possess anyone right now. And even if I could, that plan is terribly flawed. They could fight me off the same way Sans did, by harnessing the magic of their supporters. Perhaps I was wrong to turn down your help so quickly. Know this, askers from beyond the wall. My ultimate goal remains the same. I will give this wretched world the mercy that it deserves. But I will not share my plans with you. I do not want my plans to be heard by those of you who might try to warn them. But there is still something you can do to assist me, if you choose to. Lend me your power. Sans harnessed your magic to banish me from his mind, but I have other ideas.
Nope, 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 so much nope!
No, Kara, we refuse!
Noop, nap, nip, nap, nop, no, no, no.
No, no, Kara! We stand with good, and there's nothing you can do to change our mind! And for
well,
the people
Kara,
that are
does
bad,
the word
we are
screw
more.
And you
with
do
stronger.
Me power,
we
or should I think of a worse
name? And if it's evil,
Kara, so you just you don't know to when to leave well enough alone, do you? You lost once, and you'll lose again. Just stop before it's too late.
I don't trust this Kara with any power at all. Who kills their own mother?
Oh, you want my power? There's your power, you little shit.
Well, that's your choice, I suppose.
No way we would ever help you, Kara. Sure, we have some insane tendencies, but that doesn't mean there are enough of us stupid enough to help you now.
So pure, so naive. There will always be people willing to help me. Which, ironically, is why the world deserves to die. Here's one now.
Their happiness fills me with anger. Do it, Kara. Take it from them. Take it and watch as their life runs dry. Relish in the love of getting stronger.
How may we help you, Kara?
I imagine most of them will be Anons, but this is fine. I will accept any power that I'm offered.
Oh, Kara, I can help if you want us to. Just ask us and we will give you all the support you need. Let us know, yes?
Well, Kara, since you want to destroy everything, I'll agree to your lovely plan. But after that, let's grab some burgers and fries and watch the world burn! Plus, we can get some smoothies!
Looking at humanity's inevitable collapses fills me with prediction. It's going to happen very soon. Just take my energy, Kara. I won't be needing it in the future. If I stick with these idiots, I'll just face more hardships anyway. I stand corrected. I admire your integrity.
Kara, I lend you all the power I can!
Kill them all in cold blood, Kara. I'm sick of the same story over and over again. Of the good guys winning against the bad guys. Show them the real meaning of this world and tear Frisk's determination apart with every slice of your knife. You'll have my support and my power on this battle. I want to see their smile fade away into a sea of tears and pain. Let's see what good their friendship does then.
Hashtag free Satan. Hashtag free Satan. Hashtag free Satan. Hashtag free Satan. Free Satan. Free Satan. Free Satan. Free Satan. Free Satan. Free Satan.
Well, I think I'll be gone for a little while. I need time to prepare. See you later.